not. He's probably not. Yeah.
Okay. All right. That's fine.
Our guys at 87 through 6, their guys 88 through 5.
That's a lot, just give me our guys
87. 87 through 6, yeah.
Do you want to come on here? Are you doing theater?
I am.
Maybe Sarah can step in front
of you. I can do it.
Oh, yeah. You can also do it before the game, after the game. When you feel good, let me know.
That cobweb's on here, though.
Okay. I'd be happy to, anytime you feel good.
I'm on the air.
Sarah, it's new opinion.
Testing.
New opinion.
One, two.
That was a strike.
I'd be awful on it. I'd be like waiting.
Testing. One, two, three. Scott, when I announce, I'm going to cut my audio, okay, from here. Like it's cut right now.
Okay.
You can introduce me, though.
Okay. All right, we are going to the bottom of the sixth inning here at Winter Chevrolet Stadium.
Now batting the
another
center fielder.
Nip-and-tuck game, 1-1, and Wes Wallace will
Number
be leading
13,
out for the
Wes Wallace.
The Pittsburgh Diamonds. Chasing that Pacific Association Championship, they need to win one of the last five with us now to take us, join us for an inning or two. Karam Shah, the leader, the owner of the Pittsburgh Diamonds.
All right.
That pitches outside, and our leader.
Glad to be here.
And our fearless leader.
Going to try to do a couple things at the same time here.
Well, you're multi-talented. This pitch from Wallace is whacked to the left side, and it's deep to left field, and back goes Metzger, and he watches it. He has room. He's at the fence, and he makes the catch.
Wow.
Wes Wallace said about as far as you can go and still be in the field, and Betzker caught it at the fence. Diamonds were looking for a moment
now
like they might have a lead.
First baseman, number 24, Vinny Galletti.
That same Wes Wallace swing that doesn't look like it's going to go anywhere. That's certainly not anywhere near that far, and he almost hit it out again. Vinny Galletti up here with one out. Well, that put a little blood in the veins at least.
Yeah, wow. He's...
May not have been a hit, but
looked like he was going to jump.
But may not have been a home run.
It came straight down from I don't know where.
I know, it did. It was very high. And if it was up there that high, and the wind's not as strong as it was, you know, a little earlier, but that strong, it might have made a difference. This ball bounces off the plate. 1-1. So the Diamonds are here. Crum, is this the closest that you've had a team close to this championship?
Actually, last year we competed with one game to go, with two games to go in Sonoma, and we lost the second to last game, the first half,
uh-huh.
And so we were out. So we've been here last year. Yeah.
And even farther down the lane, Vigaletti hits this one, and it's off the left center field, and over comes the center fielder to make the catch.
Hung up.
So Hibbert comes over to catch that ball in left center, and the Diamonds have given two balls. Okay, we are here back here at Winter Chevrolet Stadium. We lost our audio, we think, for a brief while there. B.J. Quinn, he had two outs. There's nobody on. It's a 2-1 count now to Quinn as he steps in here with following Wallace's near home run. And Galletti's near double, but they weren't what they appeared they were going to be. That ball is a ball, 3-1. 3-1 count now to Quinn.
Yeah, another close game. You know, got shut out yesterday. Had a chance to win it. And
talk to us about signing Gwynn back. He was here last year, and he was a great player right here.
Yeah, he was here last year, and he was one of the league leaders in batting average. And
this pitcher when it's fouled off to the left side, the stompers are making an effort, but it's going to fall out of play.
And, you know, he got signed pretty much right after the first month of the season, Sioux Falls Canary. Pretty much we suffered after that. He was really one of the only guys that was hitting all the time, actually. We missed him. Now we have him back.
Now we have him back, and he came back with a double.
That's right.
His first at bat to say, hello, Pittsburgh. He's up here now with a full count, two outs, nobody on, and the 3-2 pitch from Plotter. It swung on, and this one's hit the left side. This one's in trouble. Baxter on his way back. Can he get there? Yes! Oh, my God, three times the Diamonds have hit the ball hard, almost out of the park at one point, but three times the Stompers have corralled it, and we got no runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on at the end of six. The score is Sonoma 1 and the Diamonds 1.
So I have Scott Plaza. I have him at 98 pitches.
Here we go to the
now batting
top of the seventh inning.
Number two, Eddie Moraluera.
Tony Schultz, the voice of the Diamonds, who I'd usually toss it to at this moment, is not with us. He's on vacation, so just to let you know, he'll be back next week. He's missing some tight ball games, I'll tell you. 1-0 last night. It's 1-1 here in the top of the seventh. And the Stompers are going to start with Eddie Moraluera here in the seventh inning.
Yeah, tight game again.
Well, that's a man who knows. How many pitches so far for Blackley?
Blackley has thrown 87 up to this point.
That's pitch 88 is a strike, and it's 0-1. With us, Karam Shah, the owner of the Pittsburgh Diamonds, who is doing many things, including being the official scorer and our official guest on air.
That's right.
The 0-1 pitch from Blackley, who takes a while between pitches. That pitch is inside for a ball, and it's 1-1. So Justin Lawrence is warming up in the Diamond bullpen in case Blackley reaches a level of pitches that fatigue his arm. You know, he hasn't been throwing competitively. He's been maybe throwing in practice, et cetera, but till last week when he started the game in Sonoma for Pittsburgh. This pitch is fouled back, and it's going to be 1-2. So B.J. Gwynn, we talked about him as the newest addition. He went to the American Association. Now he's back here. Did he leave Sioux City? Was he playing for Sioux City this year?
No, he was playing for the Sioux Falls Canaries. And then I'm not sure exactly who he was playing for right when he was just released.
Okay.
We can look it up. But he was hitting around 220 there in the American Association. And he was released because of that. But he was hitting better than 370, 380 here last year. So definitely a welcome sight.
So he was up last inning, and he will be up again in this game. Right now, the Diamonds are trying to dispatch with Moraluera, who's got a one ball and two strike count. Blackley comes to the plate. This ball is hit to left field, a base hit. That's your classic line drive, base hit to left field. Picking it up is Marty Carena, as a big turn is made by Moraluera as he retreats back to first now. So there's a leadoff single here.
Now batting first baseman, number 14,
Sonoma.
Scott David.
And Scott David will come up with one on and nobody out. Now, in this situation, throughout this game, both teams now had the Stompers have sacrificed twice. The Diamonds have looked like they were going to sacrifice.
And Scott David is a very
successfully
crafty player. So
Is he the type to show bunt and then pull back and hit it?
Oh, yeah. He'll hit it through the hole here. Throw over.
Throw to first. As we discussed, that is Aaron Miles' directive to all pitchers that they will throw the ball to keep the runners close. Nobody out and a runner at first. And that's a strike to David, and it's 0-1. Scott David, the first baseman.
Scott David played for the Diamonds 2 years.
Oh, really?
Actually, he was in the Can-Am League when we picked him up a couple times. He lives locally in Pleasanton or San Ramon.
Oh, great.
So definitely very fast.
Yeah, he has a
very dangerous hitter.
Deceptive speed he's got.
Very dangerous hitter.
Yeah. And he's crafty, you said, too.
That's right.
All kinds of words to describe Scott David. 0-1 count. The 0-1 pitch bounces up by McKeon. On the right is second is Mora Laura. He rounds second and looks at third as McKeon goes back to the backstop to the fence to pick up the ball way up. Kind of halfway up between home and third was that ball. And Mora Laura holds it second. So down to the runner at first, runner at second base with nobody out. And even though Scott David wasn't showing bunt as sacrifice, he now doesn't have to worry about that. But of course the big thing is here, get the runner to third where he can score.
That's right.
From a fly ball.
Now he's just looking to serve the ball somewhere. In these situations, Scott David is really, really good.
Yes. Oh, and I've noticed this last time. He has the strangest warm up with his bat. Watch, he pumps the bat up and down like that. Up and down. Other players will swing it back and forth like towards the pitcher, but his goes up and down.
Yeah, he's gonna come right down with it.
Yeah.
Hit the ball right on the top half and drive it somewhere.
Here's the pitch.
Ooh,
did it hit him? Did it hit it? His helmet goes flying.
He did hit him.
He did hit him in the back. I guess I knocked his helmet off. And so now there'll be runners at first and second. He appeared to be okay.
Now batting shortstop, number 5, Masa Miadera.
Masa Miadera will come up here, but only after Aaron Miles gets to the mound. Justin Lawrence has been warming up for a while. He has got to be warm by now if Miles wants to make a change. He'll have a discussion out there. The entire infield has to participate. I guess, you know, it's one thing, and Miles is, as a manager, has kind of the same habit. You know, if you're going to make a change, you make a change. But he's just going to come back and leave the pitcher in usually.
There's a long discussion. Discussing how they're going to rotate the wheel play here. Who's going to cover third and all that fun stuff.
And behind in the picture, you can see the ambulance and a fire truck leaving the fire station. Now, if you are concerned that they're going different directions, I remember the morning of the Northridge earthquake, walking down Santa Monica Boulevard with fire trucks and ambulances going the opposite direction all the time.
Yeah.
Well, it didn't make any sense.
Could be more than one call. You never know. But they could be heading to the same location. You never know as well.
They have different GPS
different
systems
ways
that told them to
there.
Go different ways. Look back at second. Long look back at second. Now, just standing on second base. Laura, it's was not going to move back. He was kind of daring him to throw the ball, I think. Just standing there saying, I dare you. And they didn't throw the ball.
Well, critical juncture in the game. You know, no outs, and Miadera is going to bunt.
And the Diamonds just charging up. There's Galletti in the foreground. Background, you see Bautista. They both came charging from their positions of first and third.
And now we got a helicopter.
First and second, nobody out. 1-0 count now. Man, you're up here with two base runners. Oh, the batter, I mean, the runner would come and tag it.
Sack
and he
hit.
Able to make the catch and get that hand out of the way. So they record the out. But now the Stompers have runners at second and third with one out.
Now batting second baseman, number eight, Yuki Yasuda.
Yuki Yasuda steps up here with the Diamonds are going to play the infield in there. Not going to play back in double play depth. They're going to play up all the way around the infield. Obviously, a double play would end the inning. They have runners at second. No, there's no double play. There's no one at first, so excuse me. Here's a pitch. And that's a ball. It's 1-0. So they're playing up to the top. Mora Laura is at third base. At second base is Scott David. Yuki Yasuda at the plate. A 1-0 count. One out. No, score is tied at 1-1 here in the top of the seventh inning. And now Blackley steps off the mound. Steps off the rubber, excuse me, and now he steps back on. The man from Melbourne is ready to go. 1-0 pitch.
Yeah, but as I mentioned earlier, definitely a tense situation here.
You can see in that the TV screen, you can see how far in Garcia and Valdez are playing. Right at the beginning of the infield, two balls and no strikes, a 2-0 pitch. He hits it to the left side. Bautista stops it. He looks at home and does not throw there. He throws to first instead, and that's going to score a run for Sonoma. It's 2-1. And decided it was not the play to make and went to first instead, and that scores a run for Sonoma. I can't say either way. I don't know. He didn't think it was a play. I didn't think it was an obviously going to be an out, but so that scores Eddie Moralora. And Yasuda will get an RBI. And now there are two outs.
I don't think he had a play at home.
You don't
think
so?
It looked like it would have been bang, bang. He would have had to throw right through the runner almost.
He had to wait for a high hop, and that slowed down his ability to make the play considerably. That first pitch is a ball. It's 1-0. So now the Diamonds again down by one run like they were last night for the entire game. Now here's the pitch from Blackley. Square to bunt, pull it back, strike. 1-1.
Yeah, he had to leap up there. It took a little bit. He couldn't have came in and got it. It would have gone over his head, right? So.
Yeah, he had to wait for the ball for that high hop. 1-1 count is swung on a miss. 1-1. 1-2, I mean. Matt Hibbert up here. Hibbert has been on base all three times he's been to the plate. He's walked twice, and he's been hit by a pitch. Here's the pitch to Hibbert, and he grounds this one. High bouncer to Garcia, who waits for it, takes it, throws it. Not in time, and a run scores. He had to wait for that high hop, and that took a lot of time, and Hibbert scooted down the line quickly, and he beat it out for a base hit and an RBI as Scott David came in to score. And now it's 3-1 in favor of Sonoma in the top of the seventh. The Diamonds have given up runs on two infield hits the first one was infield out, but an infield hit that time to Garcia. Both of them not hit well. I mean, Blackley pitches were good, but runs scored anyway. Now there's a runner at first and two down. So Brennan Metzger steps up here with a runner at first. The Sonoma's inning still continues. This pitch is foul, and it's going to be 1-1. So Justin Lawrence will undoubtedly pitch the next inning, and because he is ready to go, and they discussed taking out Blackley. What about the second half of the season? Not that this first half is over, but the Diamonds seem to be in good shape as far as...
Oh, I think we're going to be in great position for the second half. Winning the first half makes your second half a lot easier. So, you know, other teams are going to be improving as well. We're going to be playing a lot of games on the road. But still, I think we're going to be in pretty good shape.
There goes the runner at first. And Metzger, did he get hit by that on his foot? He
looks
danced
like
around in pain as he came out of the batter's box, and I think he got hit by that as the runner was headed to second. So Metzger is hit by a pitch, and Hibbert will go down to second base. He was running for second anyway, but... Matt Lococo comes up here now with two on, and first they're going to make sure that Metzger is okay at first base. That's the Diamonds trainer there.
Marianne's on it, so yep. She's checking him out.
That's Miyoshi, the manager for the Stompers, checking out with Marianne. That ball hit him on the foot. He danced. He kind of scooted out of the way, but apparently not quite far enough. And now he's going to give up his shin guard. And I don't know if it's a long time. He's still upset about it, obviously, and still in pain. Will he be able to stay in the game is a good question. He is an outstanding left fielder, and it would be a big loss for Sonoma. He's made some great plays, including standing at that wall and catching Wes Wallace's almost home run.
Yeah, he stood straight up. Yeah. Checked to see how far the wall was behind him, but it wasn't more than an inch, maybe. He was up against it.
Yeah, but it was right there.
He was looking to jump, and he didn't have to.
Yeah, it just came right down right to him. So he's on at first base. He and Dean Petit have a conversation, the umpire. And Sonoma is still going strong here in the seventh inning with runners at first and second. Now Matt Lococo steps up. He is flown out, grounded out, and struck out. And he steps out. Blackley taking his time. Clearly Lawrence is ready in the bullpen because he's not throwing anymore. He's just standing on the mound watching. There is someone throwing in the Sonoma bullpen. We'll have to check that out once we can see who it is. The Diamonds are dancing behind second base. Here's the pitch. It's high for a ball. It's 1-0. Out there at second base is Hibbert. And they're giving him something to think about anyway. You see he's got the lead. He's checking it out. Valdez on the right side there on your screen. Here's the pitch.
Good looking
a pitch. A strike, and it's 1-1.
So that's two hit by pitches this inning. You know, the first one, a free hit by pitch, you know, he was bunting. You know, Scott David was going to be bunting or,
yeah.
You know, he was going to try to get the guy over.
Yeah,
but
he gave up the out for the hit by pitch.
But instead he hit him, and two runs are in because of it, so.
Three to one, Sonoma leading here in the top of the seventh. They've scored two runs in this inning, and there go the runners. Here's a bound ball right up the middle. Valdez, catch. Oh, it hits the runner, and he's out. So that ball hits the runner. That's taking one back on the hit-by-pitch category.
So how do we score that?
The runner runs into the baseball, and that's an out for the Diamonds. So that will end the seventh inning, but not before Sonoma gets two runs and leaves one runner at the end of six and a half. The score, 3-1, Sonoma.
was having some issues.
The Diamonds have their work cut out for them. They're down 3-1. They're in the seventh inning. They need to beat Sonoma tonight to stay alive in this race for the Pacific Association's first half championship. Sonoma, on the other side of the fence, needs just one win to clinch that championship. And the Diamonds have 9 outs away. So they need to get some runs started and soon. Calderon at the plate. The pitch from Plaza. It's a ball. One ball and no strikes. Plaza has pitched 6 innings so far. He's done an outstanding job. He's given up 5 hits and only 1 run. The Diamonds had no runs last night. Here's a pitch to Calderon. This pitch is a strike, and it's 1-1 on the outside corner. Bottom of the 7th inning. 3-1, Stompers. The 1-1 pitch is low for ball 2, and it's 2 balls and a strike. So far tonight, Calderon has grounded out and struck out. Plaza winds and delivers 2-1. This pitch is fouled off to the left side, and it's going to go out of play, and the count will be in 2-2.
I'm very confident that Travis Blackley is done for the day. 109 pitches, gave up 3 runs on 5 hits. A couple hit Bathman. Mixed in there.
One home run taken off the board. Have you ever seen that before? Ever seen the home run taken off the board that we saw tonight in the third inning?
On a replay, possibly, but,
No, not in a
I think everyone in the stadium noticed that was definitely foul.
This pitch to Calderon is fouled away. That was in the third inning with the runner on. Yasuda hit the ball down the left field line, and it was curving, and to my eye, which, I'm not right behind home plate. I'm kind of light down that left field line. It was a foul ball curving in front of the foul pole. And the ump called it fair. And all hell broke loose. Here's the pitch to Calderon. He fouls this one away. He's having a battle with Plaza, who's now into the seventh inning. And do we know how many pitches
he's throwing? Well into, he's 103, 4, 5, 105 pitches.
So you'd think that Sonoma would be.
They got somebody warming up over there. It looks like a right-hander.
It's a right-hander with. Hard to
stretching at least. Catcher's going out.
That pitch, low for a ball. Now it's a full count to J.Q. Calderon leading off the seventh inning.
Definitely only 9 outs remaining for the Diamonds here, and they're going to have to get something going or be eliminated here.
Marty Carena on deck, and the third hitter in this inning will be Bautista. The pitch to Calderon fouled back, and the count stays at 3-2. He is having this battle with the pitcher now is over 110 pitches in a game, and that's a lot. Usually 100 is kind of the magical mark people talk about. And, of course, that can vary by competitor, but he's up there. And 3 balls, 2 strikes, a 3-2 pitch fouled away again. Maybe into that soccer field that you saw there for a moment on your I love that. I love the interviewer doing there. I wanted to look over. Soccer team getting ready for their soccer practice, and they're all throwing the football around. Which cracked me up. Here's the pitch to Calderon. Swung on, he hits this in the left side, and in the left field for a base hit.
Yeah, so he picked out his pitch. He fought off some tough pitches, and then he picked one out and laced it into left center field there for a solid base hit.
And here comes Miyoshi, and he's probably got the hook with him, I no doubt. And they got a pitcher warming up. He takes that baseball immediately. Scott Plaza will step off the mound, and he has done an outstanding job for Sonoma tonight. Held the Diamonds to 1 run. He's responsible for Calderon on to first base, but he has pitched a beautiful ball game with the championship on the line. He will now sit down here, and the Diamonds will figure out what they're going to do. They can't play for one run anymore, you don't think? They got maybe enough time, but here comes the relief pitcher in. Takes the ball. They say, go get him. Says, which way's home plate? Okay. Ryan Richardson, who we saw last week in Sonoma, comes in to pitch for the Stompers.
I'm not sure what he throws. I haven't really watched him pitch. Intensity of this game is going up here.
This is his 12th appearance of the year. He has thrown 16 and two-thirds innings. He has 22 strikeouts in those 16 and two-thirds innings, and perhaps more impressively, only 7 walks. He has given up 5 earned runs. He's given up 11 runs, but only 5 of them were earned. That's interesting. 2.70 ERA. As you know, when you come into a game as a relief pitcher, often there are runners on base, like the Diamonds have Calderon on at first. So if Calderon comes around to score, that'll be on Scott Plaza's ERA, not on Richardson's. But at the same time, the second pitcher came in and allowed the hits that or whatever that happened to score those people that were on base. So that is not a terrific indication of success when you have 11 runs scored, 5 of them earned. That means other people's runners have come around and scored. We're going here now to Javier Matacarena, runner at first, nobody out. Bottom of the seventh inning, 3-1 Sonoma, and Ryan Richardson now on the mound for the Stompers. Calderon with his lead in the first pitch to Matacarena. A ball, and one ball and no strikes. Matacarena so far tonight has struck out looking and grounded out. The Diamonds need 2 runs to tie 3 to take the lead. The pitch to Matacarena is hit high and deep.
Back.
To left field.
Way back
goes Metzger. He's at the wall. It's gone.
Gone. There it is. Yeah. All right, well, you know.
Hello, tie ball game. Matacarena with a 2-run home run in the bottom of the seventh, and the Diamonds have tied it up for 3. Well, it's in 2 hits, 2 at-bats. It's tied up, a single by Calderon, a home run for Matacarena. I don't exactly know what it was, but there was a chant coming out of the Diamonds dugout as a bunch of happy Diamonds were welcoming home Matacarena. The pitch to Bautista is a strike, and it's 1-1.
All right, we got a brand new ball game here in Pittsburgh.
That changes the tone completely. He just whacked that out, and you know, with Metzger running over there, you just weren't quite sure the ball was out of here. Here's the pitch. Bautista swings and fouls at the plate. It's 0-2. Because we saw him do that against Wes Wallace, run back to the fence, and it seemed like it took so long for the ball to get there, it had to be out of here. But no, it came down in his glove. This time it was no chance for Metzger. It was out of here, and 2 runs score. It's 3-3. The pitch from Rodriguez. That's exactly what we're talking about. That's called strike 3 on Bautista. That's what we were talking about in that ERA situation, though. Calderon on at first base. Rodriguez comes in and gives up the home run. There are 2 runs scored. Only one of them is charged to Rodriguez. So he gives up a run, but earned is only 1 run on him. So he kind of gave us a perfect example of what his show. And immediately doesn't seem so well because other teams continue to score.
Now it's 3-3. Now the bases are loaded. Alex McKeon steps up here with one out. We're in the bottom of the seventh.
The pitch from Rodriguez is a strike, and it's 1-1. On deck, Jose Garcia in the top of the diamond order.
McKeon has a hit tonight. The pitch to him, swung on and missed, strike two.
He has a hit and a sacrifice.
One for one. The Diamonds, with their backs to the wall, come right back with two of their own in the bottom of the seventh to tie this game up at three. They cannot afford a loss.
They're still alive, so.
The pitch to McKeon outside for a ball.
Didn't miss by much.
Strikes.
Yeah, good pitcher. You know, Sonoma has a really good bullpen, yeah. And it's not going to be easy.
But the first person out of the bullpen we saw was greeted with a home run by Marty Carena. And tying this ball game up, that pitch is a low and outside for a ball. It's 2-2.
Good bullpen, solid defense for the most part. It's the reason why they're ahead by four games.
Yeah. And their opening series sweep against the Diamonds that was a difficult to watch. Here's the pitch. This ball, ground ball past the pitcher. Second baseman Yasuda picks it up and throws him out for out number two here in the seventh. The Diamonds looked like in that first series they could win a couple of those first two games, and they did not. They had the lead, and they gave it up. And now it is a four-game difference, and they gave them that three-game head start at the start of this season.
Definitely got a head start. Blown save by Martinez in the first game of the season. I still can't forget it. definitely. We had some opportunities there right. In the first two games, up 3-0 in the second game, and we gave it up again.
Could have changed the entire complexion of the season, which felt like Garcia swing and miss, like the Diamonds were always chasing them, and the Sabres were like this distance away that was almost insurmountable. They proved it wasn't. And now they are here. They had a five-game winning streak until last night, and the attitude of Aaron Miles was, well, all we need is another five-game winning streak.
Another five-game winning streak, and we'll be able to accomplish our goal.
Here's the pitch to Garcia. Swing and a miss or a foul tip at the plate, and it's 0-2. But here in the seventh inning, the Diamonds get a leadoff hit by Calderon and then a home run from Marta Carena. They have tied the score at 3. In this critical, critical game, they're all critical now.
For the bullpen Pittsburgh. Game now, the Diamonds do have, Garcia gets out here, they still have the second, third, fourth batters along with the
right.
A very good rest of the lineup
that
coming
pitch
up.
Is a ball, and it's 1-2 now to Garcia. Garcia has struck out and then popped out twice. 1-2 count. Rodriguez on the mound, replacing Scott Plaza this inning. There's the pitch from Rodriguez. Garcia swings and misses for strike three.
Yeah, good dose of changeups.
And he will sit curve down
balls.
And take it out to shortstop, but that's not before the Diamonds get two runs on two hits. One of them a two-run home run from Javier Marta Carena to tie it. We're going to the eighth inning, and the score is tied at 3. Rubbing my mustache, it's other static. Because I haven't had it up against my mouth.
It sounds like it's coming from here. Because, like when I'm working around, I'm hearing.
Okay.
I don't know.
Static?
Yeah, no, he's getting. He says he is getting static.
At one time, it seemed like that was so much static, he just bounced y'all off. I couldn't even hear nothing.
Yeah, it bounced us off.
Yeah.
And then I rebooted it.
Okay.
So now it's bad or so?
Something in here.
Yeah, and I was checking.
Is it my computer? Could it interfere?
I don't think so.
Justin Lawrence will be the new pitcher for the Pittsburgh Diamonds. It may feel a little bit like they're putting their season in his hands as they go into the eighth inning here. We are tied at three. The Diamonds cannot lose another game without giving up their hopes of being Pacific Association first half champions. So Lawrence steps in here for his ninth appearance on the year. He's pitched 11 and two-thirds innings. He's got nine strikeouts and only four walks in that time, which is an outstanding number. And he's going to stand up here and face Joel Carranza to lead off here.
Very dangerous hitter, obviously.
Yeah. He lead off here in the eighth inning, and he pops it up. They're pointing over to Galletti. Galletti says he's got it right by first base on the infield dirt, and he makes the catch. So that was a quick and good way to dispose of a very dangerous hitter, Joel Carranza. He'll sit down with the pop-up. Isaac Weinrich, a good example of doing what the team needs. He is the cleanup hitter for Sonoma. And after Carranza let off the fourth inning with a single, he was called on to sacrifice bunt, which you don't usually see for cleanup hitters. And he did a fine job and successfully sacrificed Carranza over to second base. He did not score, but, you know, you do what you need to do to help the team. One out, nobody on here in the top of the eighth inning. The pitch to Weinrich is inside for a ball. It's 1-0. One-oh count. Justin Lawrence now in on the mound. He's disposed of the first batter he faced. Now on the mound, out throwing for the Diamonds is Jordan Brink. That pitch is high for a ball, and it's going to be two balls and no strikes now to Isaac Weinrich. Outside of his sacrifice, Weinrich struck out in the second inning, and he grounded out in the sixth inning. 2-0 count. The 2-0 pitch. A strike, and it's 2-1. So Lawrence has found the strike zone here. Carranza was first ball hitting. So I think someone is stuck in that light pole and sending us a message. 2-1. The 2-1 count. High, ball three. And his outstanding ratio of strikeouts to walks in danger here with a 3-1 count to Weinrich, the catcher for Sonoma. 3-3 ball game right now, eighth inning, one out. Lawrence with the pitch. Ball four. So Weinrich now is a base runner here, and he's got the potential lead run for Sonoma on at first base. Here comes Mora Laura, who scored in that seventh inning when the Stompers got two runs. Lawrence now with a runner at first base, and Weinrich. Oh, we've seen Weinrich take off for a second before the pitch is swung on a miss to strike, and it's 1-1. Not sure in this situation. I'm kind of with one out. More and more not scoring.
Well, they want to stay out of a double play here, obviously.
Try a hit and run. No balls and one strike. The 0-1 pitch. Swung on it. He hits this one to the left side, and that's deep. Back goes Wallace. Chasing, give me a chase, give me a chase. He makes the catch in left center field.
Yeah, he's showing off that great range over there in center field and reason why we have him there patrolling center field, and that's not the first big play he's made this year.
Wes Wallace all smiles out there in center field. He was on his horse racing to get that ball, lift up the glove, and not just his speed, but a good thing is how tall he is. He needed every inch of height. He needed every ounce of speed to catch up with that ball and make this second out in this inning. Out number two. And the runner was held at first base. Weinrich was almost a second when that ball was caught, and he ran back. Wallace threw it back in, but that was no chance for that. What a play by Wes Wallace in first base to keep this game tied at three. The pitch. A strike, and it's 1-1. Now up here, Scott David, former Diamond.
Little piece of their own medicine there with the defense, right?
That's right. Runner at first with two down. David trying to keep this inning alive for Sonoma. The pitch. It bounces up there. McKeon keeps it in front of him. Rushes up the third base line to get it. He's got it, and the runner does not advance. Runner at first, 1-1 count. Justin Lawrence in relief of Travis Blackley. This pitch is hit high and deep to left field, and back goes Marty Carina, and he's to the warning track, and he's looking for the wall, but he makes the catch in front of it, and that's out number three.
All right.
Marty Carina, you can feel him reach back with his right hand. Where's that wall? He put his glove up, made the catch. Out number three, we're going to the bottom of the eighth. The score's tied at three.
I don't understand what happens. When you talk loud, it begins to clip. Oh. I'm going to try to figure out why and maybe change what we're using or something. But we'll try to figure out how to solve that.
But that can't be the continuing static.
Yeah, I'm not sure. What I am sure about is we're going to the bottom of the eighth inning with a great chance to win this game here.
Okay.
I've been monitoring it.
Yep. The throw going to second here after warm-ups by Ryan Richardson as he will start the bottom of the eighth inning for Sonoma on the mound. In relief of Scott Plaza, he was greeted rudely by Javier Marty Carina in the last inning. Marty Carina hit a home run to tie this ball game at three, and then Wes Wallace and Marty Carina in the outfield made great plays. Wes Wallace racing to left center field, reaching up to stop what would have been clearly an extra base hit. Might have broken.
Yeah, the proverbial he was on his horse,
and so that was out number two, and then out number three, Marty Carina at the fence.
Big strides, galloping out there. Wasn't it?
It looks like an antelope. Here's the pitch to Devaldez, and that ball is low for a ball 1-0. The Diamonds here in the bottom of the eighth. We'll have Valdez, Wes Wallace, and Vinny Galletti coming to the plate. They need to win to stay alive. And that's the type of threats, three of the hitters they most want up there in that situation. Here's the pitch to Valdez. He squares to Bunny. Takes it. Ball two. 2-0. Hey. Two balls and no strikes. Nobody on. Her first hitter here in the eighth inning. The Diamonds have come back twice in this game to tie it. First, it was the third inning. Down by one run, they came back and tied it at one. Now in the seventh inning, they did the same thing. Valdez swings and misses. Strike two. Strike one. It's 2-1. They have 7 hits in the game. The Stompers have 5. Nobody's committed an error, and we're tied at 3 here in the bottom of the seventh. I mean, the bottom of the eighth. Excuse me. The Diamonds would dearly love to take the lead at the Stompers 3 outs and head on Thursday. Here's the pitch. Fouled away, and it's going to be 2-2 now to the Diamonds' second baseman. 2 balls, 2 strikes.
As I mentioned, you know, really good bullpen here for Sonoma. I remember Aaron mentioning that to me, that, you know, they hit on every one of their relievers pretty much that we saw earlier in the year with those 3 games that we played them. And they all did well against us. So
we'll see how that comes out here. The Diamonds have scored runs tonight. Last night they couldn't get anything. So now it's last night they lose 1-0. Tonight it's 3-3. The pitch to Valdez, ground to the right side, right at Scott David, who doesn't have to go very far to tag the base. And that's out number one.
Now batting the center fielder, number 13, Wes Wallace.
Well, here is the antelope himself, Wes Wallace. Long strides, tall frame. Make that catch in left center field, and now up here with nobody on and one out, we are in the bottom of the eighth inning. He also hit that ball to left field earlier in this game, but Metzger just planted himself at the fence, and the ball came right down his glove. Here's a pitch to Wallace. He swings and a miss, and it's a strike. It's 0-1. He almost made the home run that made the difference in that situation. Now he's back here with another shot at it. 0-1 count. The 0-1 pitch. Ball 1-1. Wallace, besides flying out, has struck out and flown out to right earlier tonight. The 1-1 pitch. Strike two. Vinny Galletti on deck for the Diamonds. At that we are at that point of the game that nobody can afford a mistake. Richardson comes to the plate, 1-2, and Wallace hits this one high, higher more than deep, and it's going to be Metzger coming on a very high fly ball, and he's out. Out number two, Vinny Galletti will step to the plate.
Yeah, he didn't have to go all the way back to the wall that time, no. But it was hit very high.
Just underneath that pitch and got a... out to the left fielder. Vinny Galletti steps in.
First baseman, number 24, Vinny Galletti.
Galletti with 2 flyouts and a strikeout so far, to his credit. He stands in here in the bottom of the eighth with nobody on and 2 outs.
I would say Vinny's due right now. Hasn't been on base yet today.
That's true, and that is very, very rare. And almost never happens. Here's the pitch to him. He swings, and that ball
foul
gets off the glove of the catcher. Did he foul tip it?
I believe he did. Looked like it, maybe.
2 down, no one on deck. B.J. Gwynn, the newest Diamond this year, an old Diamond from last year, but this year he's new as he comes back to the team. Galletti steps in here trying to keep the inning going. No balls and a strike. And the 0-1 pitch. Strike two.
That's a tough pitch to hit.
Yeah, it was... probably best to leave it alone anyway. It was a mean curve by Richardson. And now with an 0-2 count, Galletti is quickly in the hole here.
I mean, really, what could you do with that, you know?
Yeah.
Hit it the other way, maybe?
0-2 count. Richardson may try to throw the same thing. The 0-2 pitch, ball 1-2.
No, he decided to set him up with a fastball outside first.
Yeah, he's going to, you know, he'd be stupid to throw the ball in the strike zone at 0-2. Let him swing at a couple things that are bad pitches. No balls and 2 strikes. Richardson comes to the plate. And Galletti hits it down the right field line, foul right at the bullpen. And there's a
Dennis
catch.
Neal was all over it.
Oh, that Dennis Neal made the catch?
Yep. All over it.
Dennis Neal makes the catch out there. And His job is to protect the people warming up, Jordan Brink and others out there, and he did a fine job of it. That's what he's supposed to do. Gleddy up here, one ball, two strikes, and two outs. Nobody on. They're going to get rid of that baseball, and they're going to get a new one. So, and now they need more baseballs, so out comes the bat boy with a collection of baseballs. One and two with two outs. One, two count. Richardson facing Galletti here with two down and nobody on. Bottom of the eighth inning, tie score the pitch. Swung on this one in the left center field, and it's going to get down. Yes, in front of Metzger. It hits off of his body. And Galletti is on his way to second. Here comes the throw into second, and he slides safely. Vinny Galletti with a two-out double to put a runner in scoring position here in the bottom of the eighth. And here comes Miyoshi out to the mound because he may not want any more of Richardson. We'll see what we see. Miyoshi's taking the ball, and that will be it for Richardson. So he's going to call in the left-hander. He points to the umpire, and here comes the left-hander now. We're not sure who it is yet because there are no numbers on the front of these Sonoma Stomper uniforms. What number is he? Zach Wendorf is going to be the new pitcher for the Diamonds. I mean, for the Stompers. Zach Wendorf comes in here. Wendorf is on the second page of statistics for these Stompers, which is not always a good sign. He's got an ERA of 8.10. He is in his fourth appearance for the Stompers this year. He's pitched 3 1/3 innings. He has given up 3 earned runs, walked 3 batters, struck out 4. He has no wins, no losses, and no saves. He's a left-hander. He looks like he comes kind of sidewind with that delivery as we watch him warm up here. He will come in here facing BJ Gwynn, the left-hander, who has just arrived back in Pittsburgh. We don't know if Gwynn has done just an outstanding job hitting here before. I'm sure they wouldn't think about pinch hitting for him, even if they wanted to get, they might want to get a right-hander in there, but they got the lefty up next.
There is no way in the world that they're going to pinch hit for B.J. Gwynn.
So we are sure B.J. Gwynn will be coming up here against Wendorf with Vinny Galletti on at second base. Galletti with that line drive double into left field that Metzger tried to make a great play on. It hit his body, and he bounced it into center field, and with that, Galletti decided this is going to be two, and he went into second base and slid in before they could make a tag.
There are two right-handed batters in the Diamonds dugout right now, Chad Heiberger and Corey Mello. Corey Mello being a switch hitter. And B.J. Gwynn is still one of the best hitters in the league right now, so even though this is his first game, so it's going to be left-on-left matchup.
Right now, here it is. Right now, B.J. Gwynn is hitting .333, so that's good. He will step up here. He's got a double his first time up. He's digging himself a hole at the back of that batter's box. He wants to be just perfect. And he's got a runner at second. There are two down. There's a new pitcher for Sonoma, Zach Wendorf here. And the season is on the line for the Diamonds. There's a chance to take the lead. The pitch to Gwynn. A ball, and it's one ball and no strike.
That is a tough pitch to take, too. A curveball, you know, coming in from that angle.
On deck.
He's seen it now, though.
Calderon. If Gwynn keeps this alive, the pitch to Gwynn. Outside for ball two, and it's 2-0.
He's got a base open. Another lefty.
Yeah. They may be thinking they don't want to deal with Gwynn. They've heard stories about him from last year. They probably saw him last year.
They saw him last year, yeah. And he punished everybody.
Yeah, that's we don't want to deal with that person. Of course, they pitched to Gletty and paid for it. Here's the pitch to Gwynne. He pops this one up to the left side. It could have fallen in the left field. Metzger comes in, makes the catch. So Gwynne with a short fly ball to left field is the third out here in the eighth inning, and he leaves Vinny Gletty at second base. We're going to inning number 9 here in Pittsburgh, and the score is tied at 3. Well, it's the ninth inning here in Pittsburgh. We have decided nothing. Score is tied at 3. The Diamonds and the Stompers fighting for their baseball lives. The Diamonds are anyway. They need to win to stay alive here in this first half. They have to win all 5 remaining games, and that, of course, starts with this one, game number 1 of the last remaining games. The Stompers, if they can pull it out tonight or any of those 5 games, they will be the first half champions. Right now it's tied at 3 as we go to the top of the ninth inning. Mesa Mayadora steps in here to lead off. And the first pitch is whacked to left side. Garcia in the hole. He stops it. Long throw across the diamond. Yes, he got him. Almost impossible play from Garcia going into the hole to stop the ball. And with his momentum going away, here's a replay. Bound into the corner. Look at Garcia way into the hole. Stops, picks it up, throws it all the way across the diamond and makes it. And Mayadora with that dive. And we've seen that before. And it slows you down. When you take your feet off the ground, you stop making speed. And you're supposed to run through that. Maybe you would have made it. But that's out number 1. And so that's 6-3. And that quite doesn't tell the story, is it? 6-3 in your scorecard doesn't quite tell the story. Here's a pitch. A strike, and it's on the outside corner for a strike. It's 0-1. Yuki Yasuda up here in the ninth inning with 1 out and nobody on. 0-1 count. Lawrence kicks and delivers 0-1. The pitch is swung and a miss. Strike 2. Lawrence in relief of Travis Blackley, who pitched an outstanding game for the Diamonds. They are here staring, keeping the season alive in the face. It looked bleak when they went down 3-1 in the eighth inning. This pitch bounces up there and it's 1-2. Then they immediately came back in the 3-1 in the seventh inning. They immediately came back and scored 2 runs of their own on a Marty Carina home run to tie the ball game. And that's where we stand here in the top of the ninth. 1 out, nobody on. Lawrence set. He looks in. Here's the pitch. Swung on a miss. And that will do it for Yasuda. There are now 2 down here in the ninth inning. And up comes Matt Hibbert.
Now batting center fielder, number 1, Matt Hibbert.
So Matt Hibbert who was running the opposite direction of Metzger on that hit by Galletti. And he was going to back up Metzger, except the ball hit Metzger as he make a diving attempt to catch it. And it went past Hibbert the opposite way into center field, which allowed Galletti to get to second. But the Diamonds were not able to take advantage of that two-out double, and so we're still tied. This pitch to Hibbert is swung and a miss to strike, and it's 0-1. Two down, no one on. Top of the ninth. Tie ball game, 3-3. Justin Lawrence with his pitch. It bounces up there and past McKeon. Ball one, 1-1. There's Lawrence now getting back on the mound. He's making sure his office is just the way he wants it before he goes back to work. I don't like this ball. Yeah, throw that out. One count. Now he's ready to go. Wind is now blowing fiercely out to left field. 1-1 pitch. Swung on a miss. Strike two. Diamonds are one strike away to getting to sudden death baseball in the bottom of the ninth. They can score a run and end it. First, they have to dispose of Matt Hibbert here with one ball and two strikes, and Lawrence's pitch is a ball. 1-2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Nobody on. Two down. The pitch. That's low for ball three, and the count goes full at 3-2 now to Matt Hibbert. He taps the plate, Hibbert does, and he's ready to go here. 3-2. Lawrence kicks. This swung on a miss, strike three, and the Diamonds have put them down in the top of the ninth and set themselves up for a sudden-death win if they can pull off a score. It's going to the bottom of the ninth to score Sonoma 3 and Pittsburgh 3. Richardson? Oh, Zach Waldorf? Let's see. That's it. That's my old company that I work for. The people in the Bay Area. The bottom of the ninth, tie ball game. The season on the line. The Diamonds have it all where you would want it. Calderon steps up to the plate. We told you about our interview earlier today before the game started. He went back to his father's funeral. He comes back. He says he wants to, in the future, to be working to make people aware of Alzheimer's disease and its impacts. That was, of course, one of his father's major medical issues. And now he steps in here. Any diamond run will keep their season going till tomorrow. Zach Wendorf on the mound. He pitches. It's low for a ball. Wendorf has faced, before coming in tonight, he had faced every team in the association once and pitched one inning against each team. one in the third innings against San Rafael. He pitched last Thursday against the Diamonds and gave up a run, not an iron run. This pitch is fouled off, and Joe Torre just watches it go by, the third base coach. But I wouldn't have been watching it. I think I would have been on that grass in about 2 seconds. There's Joe in the background. He says, well, my beard's still here. Done that close. 1-1 count. To Jake Calderon, bottom of the ninth, tie score 3-3. The pitch to Jake. He takes it. It's a strike, and it's 1-2. Jordan Brink, I think, is still warming up in the Diamond bullpen. If there's a 10th inning, here's a pitch to Calderon, and it's outside for a ball, and it's 2-2. Javier Marty Carena and Bautista also set to come up here in this ninth inning. A 2-2 count. The wind has died down considerably. The 2-2 pitch inside. It's a full count now to Calderon, 3-2. 3-2. Wendorf with the ball behind his back. Come set. A full count to the Diamonds right fielder. He takes his pitch and fouls it away to left side, and it stays at 3-2. Does he need a new bat? No. We need new baseballs. He took a walk out of the batter's box, sometimes looking like some people do when they need a bat after they broke it. But that bat is working perfectly fine, he says. He's going to step back in here. Left-hander against left-hander. 3 balls, 2 strikes. The pitch. Inside, ball 4. Calderon is on at first base, and the Diamonds have the leadoff man on base here in the bottom of the ninth. And so, Marty Carena, Mr. Home Run himself, will come out here, but first, Miyoshi is going to visit the mound, and we don't know if that's going to be it for Zach Wendorf or not, but he's a man on a mission that way. Miyoshi comes out here. Give me that ball, you're out of here. And he says, I'm with the right-hander. And now Mello has come out as a pinch hitter. No, he hasn't. I'm sorry, that's Marty Carena. I thought that was Mello, but it is Marty Carena. Now we've got a new pitcher for Sonoma. Who is it? DJ Shirabi is the new pitcher. For the Stompers. He'll come up here with a runner at first and nobody out for Sonoma, for Pittsburgh. He will come.
Pitch for Sonoma, number 11, DJ Shirabi.
Shirabi comes in to face Marty Carena. With nobody out and a runner at first base, and he has pitched a lot this season. He has been in 12 games. This is his 13th appearance. His record is 2-2. He has no saves. He pitched against the Admirals over the weekend, and he got the loss in their game on Saturday when they lost the first of two games they would lose to Vallejo. Against the Diamonds, he pitched on Tuesday. He pitched on Wednesday and Thursday, games that they lost, but he did not get involved in any of those decisions. His record, 2-2, as we said, on the year. His ERA is 3.11, and he comes in here with a runner at first base, Calderon, and nobody out in a tie ball game in the bottom of the ninth. The Diamonds must win to stay alive in the race. It's the Sonoma. For Sonoma, a victory means they are the champions of the first half. Sharabi, I think, is ready, or at least now he's standing up there. And here comes Marty Corena to the plate.
Now batting the left fielder, number 10, Javier Marty Corena.
Marty Corena steps in here with so much on the line. You can hear Marty Corena's walk-up music in the background. Each player, of course, gets to pick their walk-up music as they come to hit. So Javier, you think he's going to do a little dance in that batter's box the way this is going? Here we go. And he should do a little dance after his home run that he hit that tied this ball game up back in the seventh inning. Now he comes up in the same position with a runner at first and nobody out. This pitch is high for a ball, and it's 1-0. Calderon in that inning had singled, and then Marty Corena homered him home. This time, Calderon drew a walk. He's on at first with nobody out. 3-3 ball game. A 1-0 count on Marty Corena. The 1-0 pitch. Swung on and fouled back, and it's 1-1. They play him deep and straight away, very deep and left. Kind of medium depth in center and right. Straight away on the infield, hoping for the double play. Bautista is in the on-deck circle. A 1-1 count. High, ball 2, 2-1. The Diamonds have the potential winning run at first base. They have nobody out here in the ninth. And Marty Corena obviously not set up here to sacrifice. The 1-0 pitch, the 2-1 pitch. I'm sorry, ball 3, 3-1. That was a 2-1 pitch. It's ball 3 now. 3-1 count to Marty Corena. And DJ Sharaba is in facing the chance of walking the potential winning run into scoring position. Calderon with a short lead at first. Marty Corena holding on to his hat at home. 3-1 count. The 3-1 pitch. High ball 4, and it's and Calderon is on his way to second. Marty Corena is on his way to first. Nobody out here, and here comes Bautista. Now, will they bunt with Bautista? Do they sacrifice the runner to third?
Now batting the third baseman, number 6, Gerald Bautista.
They have got two straight walks. That one on 5 pitches. Different pitchers. Wendorf walked Calderon. Sharaba walked Marty Corena. Bautista comes up here, and I have to think that if you're the Diamonds, you have got to be bunting. you've got the winning run, potential winning run at second base with nobody out. You've got to try to bunt him to first, third base. I just think that's got to be it. I don't know. What do you think, bunt? I think you got to bunt. Well, I know what the Stompers think because look at that. The first baseman, Scott David, is almost halfway home at the moment. You can see him right there if you're watching on TV, number 14 right there. Here's the pitch, and he's swinging away, and he fouls it back. Bautista swinging away. Runners at first and second. So, I don't know if that was meant to put those people back on one play. Let's see. 0-1 count on Bautista. The 0-1 pitch, he's not bunting. He bounds to the left side, but it's foul at the plate, and it's going to be 0-2. So the bunt did not appear, and now it's 0-2, and that makes the bunt pretty much out of the question anyway. Runners at first and second. So Aaron Miles, the manager of the Diamonds, eschews the bunch. This pitch is popped up high and foul and back and out of play. 0-2. Nobody out. Runners at first and second. Now, Weinrich wants to have a discussion with his pitcher, and he will get out there and say, throw the ball where he can't hit it. And he's done. 0-2 count. The winning run, potential winning run, standing at third base in the person of J. Ku Calderon. also served today as our interpreter and did a fine job. Here's the pitch. Outside for a ball. It's 1-2. He interpreted our interview with Ordemar Valdez. Another, all those Dominican guys hanging out. And those are a fun group of people. He's got his lead at second. Serrano looks back, comes to the plate. He reaches out and hits this one foul. It's going to go out of play, and the count stays at 1-2. Bautista in his own battle here now with Serrano. We are in the bottom of the ninth in a tie ball game. Two runners on and nobody out for Pittsburgh. Almost impossible situation for Sonoma, but they're trying to get out of it. The pitch to Bautista, bound to the left side. In comes the third baseman. He makes a stop. He goes to second for one. It's for the first, not in time. And so the Diamonds do get a runner to third base with one out. And that is almost like a sacrifice. Runners at the corners. Bautista beats out the double play attempt. And so now they've got first and third and one out. So Corey Mello is going to come up and hit. Away. Jake Calderon standing at third base. Gilbert Bautista standing at first base. He is really more important to Sonoma than to the Diamonds. What will Sonoma do? They will come in. Of course, they'll play the infield in. They won't attempt another double play that may not be successful while the winning run scores. So they're going to play to stop Calderon from getting across the plate. And now I'm going to have the hiccups. That's a bad time for the hiccups. All right, Corey Mello steps in here. Switch hitter. Backup infielder. Gets to step in here. He's been in some tight situation. Do they walk him? Oh, they're going to walk him. They're intentionally walk Mello. So they get a force at every place and home. And Jose Garcia will come to the plate. So now there will be runners at first, second, and third. The Sonoma Stompers have the infield in. We are in the bottom of the ninth inning. The Diamonds need a win to stay in the fight. They lost last night 1-0. Tonight it's 3-3, bottom of the ninth. DJ Chiraba on the mound. Jose Garcia comes in here. He is 0-4 tonight, but he is one of the leaders in the league in hitting. He's had an outstanding season. We also had a great interview with him today. Garcia walks in here hitting 309. Would he try a – here's a pitch. It's a strike. It's 0-1. Would he try to bunt his way on base? A lot of room down that third base line. Here's the pitch to him, and it is a strike. And quickly, Sharab is out in front of Garcia, 0-2. Calderon at third. He is the potential winning run. Bautista at second. On first base is Mello. Here's the pitch to – Garcia swings and misses. He missed the ball. He's going to race down there, but he cannot. Now they've got Calderon in a runoff at third base. Can they get a double play on this? Now Calderon racing down. The throw. Is he going to stay alive enough to get? He's out. Now. Hold on a second. The question here is. This is Mello. Bautista has just come across the plate. Here's what the argument will be, that Garcia was out at home, and they lost the ball. He ran to first base. I'm not sure he had the ability to do that. I think he was just out. I should have been a strikeout. Then they got Calderon in third in a runoff, and they say that was just because the product Heath didn't know if he had to run home because Garcia was on his way to second. It may be a double play. If it's not a double play, Bautista may have scored. I think the Diamonds have just run themselves out of the ninth inning. Because Garcia does not have an ability to take first base on the strike. Then Calderon thought that there was an attempt to an ability to run home, and he took off, but he was tagged out in a runout. And so Jordan Brink will come in and pitch the ninth inning, and it's a very confusing end to this game, or end of the ninth inning, but the Sonoma Stompers have stayed alive here to go on to the 10th, and at the end of 9, it's tied at 3.
Pittsburgh, number 19, Jordan Brink. Ladies and gentlemen, we are playing international rules here for extra innings. The last two outs of the previous inning, the last two batters that were out, are now on first and second base.
Hello and welcome to the 10th inning. And yes, we will start with the international rules with runners at first and second. The last two batters, the last two people in the lineup before the first batter of this inning. That was a very confusing end of the ninth inning. We'll go back through it again because I didn't help very much help anybody understand what was happening because it was very confusing. Hibbert is at first base. Yasuda is at second base for Sonoma, as we start this 10th inning, and we lead it off with the top of the order for them, and that means Brendan Metzger will step in here. Metzger, remember, had a very sore foot earlier in the game after he hit the ball, or got hit by a pitch, and he stayed in the game, and he's here, and he's made some good plays. Now, Sonoma will start out with a sacrifice bunt, it looks like, as Metzger's not trying to hide that. They're dancing around behind second base, trying to get Yasuda a little bit, but Garcia is playing deep at shortstop, while Valdez is short at second base. Brink has come in to pitch, and the pitch is a high pop-up of a bunt, picked off by Brink, and delays his throw to second, and he could have had him maybe if he had thrown it a little earlier, but he caught the ball and then didn't realize he could get him at second and threw it too late, and he drew Garcia off the bag and almost threw it in the center field, but that was a break for the Diamonds on that first hit of this the first batter of this 10th inning, supposed to be a bunt, and instead it is a pop-out. So now, coming to the plate will be Matt Lococo, with runners at first and second, and nobody out. Now let's go back to the bottom of the ninth. The Diamonds had the bases loaded with one out. Garcia at the plate. He swings and misses strike three. The ball gets away from the catcher. Because there was a runner at first base, an usual play, if the ball gets away from the catcher on strike three, you can run down to first, and if you can beat his throw, you get the base. This pitch is outside for balls 1-0. Garcia, thinking that he could do that, breaks for first base, but he's already out because when there's a runner at first, that is not the possibility. And so that was the second out of the inning. I think that confused the base runners, thinking maybe they all have to move up a base in this situation, and Calderon was off a third. He got in a rundown, and he got tagged out, and that was out number three for the inning. This pitch is a strike, and it's 1-1. Jordan Brink now on the mound with runners at first and second, the international rules that they have here in the Pacific Association for extra innings. You get the last two batters before the man who comes up to the plate to lead off the inning. They go to second base and to first base. That's where they are. The first batter in this inning bunted, tried to have a sacrifice bunt, and he bunted it in the air back to the pitcher for out number one, and that's where we stand. This pitch swung and a miss by Matt Lococo. It's one ball and two strikes to him with one out. And there, I think we're caught up. Maybe I only confuse things more. One ball and two strikes. Runners is first and second. 3-3 ball game. It means everything in the world to these Pittsburgh Diamonds, and they ran themselves out of the bottom of the ninth inning. One-two count. Garcia dancing behind the runner at second. This pitch, a 1-2, is outside. That was a tough pitch to take, but 1-2 count. Two balls and two strikes on deck for the Diamonds. I mean, for the Stompers, their big man, Carranza. Of course, the Diamonds would like a double play to not have to face him at all in this 10th inning. Here's a Brink. Kicks his leg and goes back towards second. Yasuda heads back to the base himself. No throw. Here's Brink's pitch, and that's low for a ball. And it's full count now, 3-2 on Matt Lococo. Three and two count. Brink, the Diamonds closer, with the ball behind his back. Now comes set at the belt. Looks back at second a couple times. Comes to the plate, 3-2. Pitch fouled away. There it goes. You can see it on TV off into the distance. 3-2 count. We'll go again. It's almost impossible, it seems, to come out of these innings with holding the team that's hitting scoreless because they start with those two runners on. It just makes such a difference in everything. The pitch to Brink, high and outside for a ball, and now they're loaded up. Such as this. You walk one batter, you got the bases loaded. That's what the Diamonds have done here, and now they'll face Joel Carranza, who will come up here with no place to put him. There are stompers at every base. Carranza, last night, hit a home run in the first inning that held up through the entire game, and they won 1-0 tonight. It's 3-3. We're in the top of the 10th. One out. Diamonds are hoping to get a double play as they play back at second and short. And up at first and third, the pitch is inside for a ball. Brink really threw the hell out of that one, but it was inside. 1-0 count. Ball two, 2-0. So now the pressure's on Brink here with a 2-0 count, and they stompers everywhere that he needs to come over over the plate and give Carranza, their big guy, something close to hit. 2-0 count. Fouled at the plate. It's 2-1. And that went off somebody, but Heiber says, I'm fine. It says, I don't know who went off of, but I'm okay. Heiber in the game after Alex McKeon was pinch hit for by Corey Mello. It was Mello was given an intentional walk, and that was when Garcia came to the plate with one out and the bases loaded, and all of a sudden there were two outs and the inning was over. That pitch low for a ball, and it's 3-1 to Carranza. Yasuda at second base. No, Yasuda at third base, excuse me. Hibbert at second base. Metzger is on at first. The bases are loaded with speed for stompers, and Carranza at the plate. The 3-1 pitch, ball four, and Carranza will go to first, and the stompers will get a walk, a run. Jordan Brink walks in a run here. And there is nobody throwing in the Diamonds bullpen. So Jordan Brink's... He's given up a run. Like we said, it's almost impossible not to get a run. And as we said, as you should be aware, in the bottom of the 10th, the Diamonds will start with the same advantage, those two runners on, first and second. But right now, they need to hold the damage to a minimum to give themselves a chance in that bottom of the 10th. Isaac Weinrich steps up here with his bases still loaded. One out. First pitch to Weinrich. Is a strike, and it's 0-1. There's Vinny Galletti at first base, paying no attention to Carranza, who's behind him as a runner. His bases are loaded. Here's a pitch. It's inside for a ball, and it's 1-1. Diamonds and Stompers, 4-3 Sonoma. If they win tonight, they are the Pacific Association champions. And right now, they got the lead in the 10th inning. Jordan Brink trying to keep it that close. Pitch is whacked right by Brink, and it goes up the middle of the field. Valdez steps on second. Can he turn it fast enough to throw? No. Another run will score. It was a very difficult play for Omar Valdez. I was actually surprised he got the ball at second base, and he's tagged on second, so the runner is out there, but Carranza is out at second, and there's now two down and runners at the corners. Two down, runners at the corners.
Now batting third baseman, number two, Eddie
Moraloera. Eddie Moraloera steps up here. The Diamonds need to hold it to this 5-3, the score in favor of the Stompers. Top of the 10th. Moraloera, the third baseman. steps up here with two down. That pitch, a strike, and it's 1-1. The Stompers started with two runners on, of course, first and second, as they do with these extra inning rules. And two runners were promptly walked by Jordan Brink, loading the bases and then scoring a run on that. And then they scored a run on a ground ball. This pitch is low for a ball, and it is 1-1. I'm not sure that the Stompers don't have a hit in the inning. They've scored this run without having a hit all inning. A ground ball and two walks, and that's their offense. Here goes the runner from first. Here goes the pitch. Heiberger throws to second, and they got this guy out. Now they're going to try it home, and Heiberger can't get him. He swept past the plate, but Heiberger can't tag him, and he scores. The runner at third broke for home on the throw to second, and the throw came down and made Heiberger leap for it, but the runner went past the plate, and he came back and tagged it as Heiberger was unable to make the tag. So now Sonoma has scored three runs, and they have a runner at second. Weinrich is on at second base now as he went down there. The ball was thrown back to home plate as the runner came from third, and they were not able to get him there. That pitch is outside. It's 6-3 now in favor of Sonoma. A 2-2 count on Mora Laura at the plate. Matt Lococo scored from third base. Here's the pitch from Brink. He swings and misses. That's strike three, but not before Sonoma puts three runs on the board here in the top of the 10th inning, and they lead it going to the bottom of the 10th, 6-3. Jacob Cox.
Now pitching for Sonoma.
Jacob Cox, 24.
Number 24, Jacob Cox.
The Diamonds are behind the Stompers, 6-3, but wait, the tying run is coming to the plate. So that's the way it is with these new rules. And here comes Odomar Valdez. He'll have Chad Heiberger at second base, Jose Garcia at first. They got speed on the base pass. They got Odomar Valdez up here, and he'll be followed by Wes Wallace and Vinny Galletti. So just when you thought it was time to be glum, things are looking good. First and second, nobody out. That's the way you start in this way, in the way we play these games now in the extra innings. And here comes Valdez, and he's going to face a very familiar face, Jacob Cox, who was on the mound last night with the Diamonds. We're trying to score in the ninth inning, and they got runners at second and third, but could not get them across the plate to pitch. It's a ball. It's 1-0. One ball, no strikes to Valdez. The 1-0 pitch, outside, ball two. 2-0. So now, with runners at first and second, I would think Valdez might be making him throw a strike, but you never know. He might get the, you know, one that Aaron Miles plays an aggressive brand of baseball. The 2-0 pitch. And he's swinging away, and gets it foul, 2-1. Two balls, one strike. Heiberger on second base. There's Garcia at first. Jacob Cox on the mound. Race replacing DJ Schirabi. He's the fourth pitcher tonight for Sonoma. And he's up here against Valdez with a 2-1 count. And the 2-1 pitch is lifted left side down the left field line. It's a base hit. Here comes Heiberger around third. He will score. Garcia goes to second and holds. And it's now 6-4. Valdez with a line drive down the left field line. Metzger came over to get it, but not before the speedy Heiberger was around third and on his way to the plate. Now they're running at first and second with nobody out, and here comes Wes Wallace. Sonoma with a two-run lead. The tying run now is at first base. The potential winning run is at the plate in the form of Wes Wallace. The pitch. A ball. It's 1-0. On deck, Vinny Galletti. Garcia and Valdez, perhaps the two fastest diamonds on this base pass. Swing and a miss for Wallace. 1-1. So if you wanted two people on the base pass, you'd probably pick Garcia and Valdez, and they're out there. Wallace at the plate. And Vinny Galletti following him. Those are two players you want at the plate. This pitch is fouled back. The Diamonds have what they want, but they're down by two more runs. They got one in here. It's 6-4. There's nobody out. They're trying to get themselves situated in the outfield or wherever they want to be here for the stompers. They're not making any big changes that I can see. They're dancing around a little bit behind Garcia at second base. Here's the pitch. Wallace swinging a miss on a pitch in the dirt, and that's going to be strike three. So now it'll be Vinny Galletti coming to the plate with one out, runners at first and second. Galletti followed by B.J. Gwynn. So we'll see how this goes. He's back there. B.J. Gwynn is back there to protect Galletti in just this type of situation. Make sure they don't try to walk around Galletti. They don't want to face Gwynn. They also don't want to put the tying run in second base. Here's the pitch to Galletti, and it's a strike. It's 0-1. High and outside, it looked, but it was just not high and not inside enough, or outside enough to get the strike zone. One strike on count on Galletti here. Two on, one out. 6-4. Sonoma leads, 10th inning. The pitch. Swung on left side. It's going to go to the third baseman. He picks it up. He goes to second for one. He's on to first. Not in time. And Galletti beats it out. Coming in to score, Garcia. And now Galletti will not go to second because the ball's free, but Galletti is running down the first baseline. And are they going to give him second? Maybe they'll give him second automatically. There's an argument about that, but Garcia kept coming, and he scored 6-5, and they're going to put Galletti on second base in scoring position with two down. RBI for Galletti. So Garcia at second base kept running as that ball was thrown from second to first. No reason not to, really. If they get the double play, they don't. If they don't, they're probably not going to get you. They tried the throw home. Garcia scored sliding easily. And then the ball was a wild throw. It went up into the fence here, and I don't know if it got caught up somewhere or what, but Galletti is awarded second base on the play. And so now they have...
Now batting number 12, B.J. Gwynn.
Galletti hits into a fielder's choice. Garcia... or Valdez... Two runs have scored. This pitch, a strike. Gwynn is up here with two outs. A runner at second, the tying run. It is 6-5 in favor of Sonoma. If they get the out, they get the championship. If the Diamonds get a run, we go more innings. Or if they get two, we play another day. The pitch. Swung on a foul away, and quickly Gwynn's in a hole. 0-2. It has been a wild, wild game here. We've had a home run taken off the board. We've had, because of a discrepancy about whether it was a foul ball or went inside the foul pole, outside the foul pole, we've had the Diamonds run themselves out of the game in the ninth inning, and then they have to run themselves into the game here in the tenth. Here's the pitcher going right at the third baseman. He charges. He makes the catch. That was the first base. He got the man, and the Sonoma Stompers are the first half champions of the Pacific Association. If you're watching on TV, you can see it. If you're listening on the radio, you can hear it. And that's the chance, the celebration at the center of the field on the Diamonds, on the pitching mound by the Pacific Association champion, Sonoma Stompers. What a game that was. The Diamonds fighting down to the last breath, the last run. The last two nights coming back with a huge comeback last week. Gaining four games on Sonoma in 5 days and set this situation up at home, and they just were not able to come through, losing twice by one run. And Sonoma has won the championship by a score of 6-5 here and 10 innings in Pittsburgh. And that was an unbelievable finish to quite a wild 2 weeks of baseball we've had here with the Diamonds, not to mention the whole season, the whole first half of the season. The Diamonds will finish the second half of the season tomorrow night at home, and then they'll go to three games in Sonoma. And then on Tuesday of next week, the second half will start, and everyone will start with a record of 0-0.
We have extras? We had enough?
That's the end of tonight's game, and the Diamonds will be finishing in second place this year in the Pacific Association. They can make it a lot closer if they win a couple of games here. We'll see what happens. Thank you for joining us, and for everybody here in Pittsburgh Diamond Land, thank you for listening and watching, and we will hope to see you tomorrow night. Bye-bye.
Nice to meet you. And if you make a trip up the second half, say hello. Yeah. Okay, good. Great. Well, thank you. Nice meeting you.